So for the easy storage of the initial value, we know LoadMess would do that for you. So you can actually click on your LoadMess, double click on it, and snap 20 dB like that. So without it, you could still set the initial value. This is still useful for performances because you set your, let's say, your mic level, your various devices to the level you want, except that when you're on stage and having to save something quickly, the PA guy will say, you know, can you just lower your direct sound or something, and it's going to be not minus 20 but maybe minus 40 or something very low. And what you do is you can just go ahead and edit this, so next time if you have to close the computer, you know, during other sound check and come back before concert, this will be there. Except that when you are rehearsing, it's cumbersome to do that sometimes, and you have to act quicker. So in that case, you could have autopadder object. Is this too small? Autopadder object. So what autopadder does is automatically saves your, it saves the values of, be careful, all the max for live objects, which means live gain and these guys. If you are using other objects than max for live objects, you won't, so you have to do something else. For example, you won't store the values like that if you have them. So you have to do something else. So let's say I want my direct to be like this, maybe a delay value like this, master there, and I'm just doing some random thing. Pitch a shifter very loud, something like that. And then what you do is save. Let's say, just gonna say pattern test or something. And, why did I save it? I forgot what I saved it. Anyway, so I will go pattern test. And look, it remembers, right? Okay, so I'm changing the numbers, I'm saving it, reopening it, it will not save it. See that? So if you want to save other objects than the MX for Live, you could do two things. You can do, the quick way to do it is to use a object patter. There's a whole family of patter objects. So this is one of the first ones. So patter, so this is important, middle, not left, not right, middle outlet, and connect it like this to the number. And you could actually name them if you like. So let's say patter Mari number Marian Mari 1 or something. Okay, so here, middle to the object you're binding to. That's what this is, binding to. So now I'm going to change some things, save, reopen, and see, did I not change that? Okay, let's try. Yeah, so it remembers, right? Okay, so that's auto patter, and this is very useful. Lower your direct sound, Mari, we don't need it. Okay, you know, more, you know, delay sound and pitch sound and pitch shifting or whatever, and this is a master about there, whatever. And okay, all right, so your sound check is done, save, you go have your dinner, come back for the concert, and it's still there. So that's auto patter. But for example, if you have different settings, okay, so this is my setting for, I don't know, roulette in Brooklyn, and you have another venue, you know, I don't know where, in a smaller venue, you want a little more direct, you know, something like that, not too much delay, maybe still that, like that. Okay, my setting has changed. right, from the previous venue. And if I save it, as I just did, and I reopen it, it will save what you just saved. But you forgot what I used at the roulette. It looked like this more or less, right? So that is gone. So in that case, you need two different settings or more. So you could use a object. It's actually the parent of this whole family of patter object. It's called patter storage. Okay. So this is a huge object. So I'm just going to do an intro of it. Look at this. Oh my gosh, right? Oh, anyway. So now I have a patter storage in it. And I will double click this. And the little window like this appears. It's called client window. And it has everything that's been remembered, patterized, they say. So 1, 2, 3, 4 gains, and see the number, right? So they're all matching. And it gives you the name when I gave it a name. I did not give a name, so it gives you like a bogus, ugly names like that. Okay, also you notice client object, this weird number. Because pattern storage, you can give a name. And I think I recommend that you actually do give a name. So let's see, Mari test or something. I have so many Mari tests. Okay, so Mari test. Now, so now the client window says it's a Mari test. Okay, so let's remember these numbers, whatever. Just different. Okay, so I'm going to save this and watch. I'm closing it and then boom. Nothing happened. Okay. I thought something will happen. Here, I will make something happen. Okay. So let's say this is my first setting. So you use a message store. You can store one and store two. Eventually we'll use a hated dollar one sign, but let's just do this for now. And use just simply recall it with a number. So, okay, so this is my first setting. Okay, and I'm just changes. And this is my second setting. And then I clicked it, right? Okay, so recall first setting, second setting, first setting, second setting. First thing, I mistook, now this is the first thing because I just clicked on it. I just wanted to change these guys so we can, big number, this is store, and let's just make a different setting, and I'm just going to make this smaller into the minus, so store. Okay, so first setting, second setting, right, so they're all different. Like that. Okay, so now I have two settings. Okay, the fun thing to do is actually when you recall it, you can put the float number in, it's the same thing. However, if you scroll down, you can actually interpolate it, which is the best feature, I think, one of the best features for me, at least, of the pattern storage. You can have different setting. For example, you can still do something like a function table you already saw. So let's say, let's recall the first one. So I'm just gonna make a pattern. Oh, so this is not a max for live objects. So my function or something, oops. You can do this and bind it here. By the way, if you don't want to use these guys, you can actually go to, let's see, you know what I'm going to do? I'm just going to do another function table because it's fun. Okay, oops. Function table. And then you can go to the inspector and you find any non-max for live objects that you want to include, you have two ways. You can pattern it by connecting from the middle outlet to the object you want to patternize, or you can go to the inspector and you find this scripting name under name, and you say, let's say, function Mari. Okay, what this is Mari function 2, because this is Mari function, right? So I go like that, and now let's look at into the storage. So I have Mari function is this one, and Mari function 2 is this one, right? So I have two of them. Okay, so now let's just make, is this my first setting, right? So let's say you're connected to some kind of a sound thing, and I don't know, here. Okay, so oops, so I'm going to store this again, and then let's recall number 2. So I'm gonna change this. I don't know, it doesn't matter. Something like that. Anyway, something different, right? So store it. Okay, so recall 1, recall 2, right? Recall 1, recall 2. So, oh, this is fun. See, 1, 2, 1, 2, wee hoo, wee hoo. Okay, so now, 1, 2. Okay, so you can interpolate between the two settings. That's what I wanted to show. So now watch it. This is, I'm gonna save this. I'm gonna close it now. Watch carefully. This save window appears, and it says Mari test. Remember, I named Mari test, and the pattern storage is named Mari test. And you see file format is pattern storage JSON preset file. JSON stands for JavaScript object something, I forgot the acronym, but that is what's storing your two settings. So if you store more than one setting, this window will appear. So where did I save my, yeah, pattern test, right? So you have to put it in the same window, or you save as a project, and we'll save it with you. But just, you know, for now, just put it in where your this is where the my patch was. So in the same place, and you say save. I apparently had another one, so replace. Okay, so let's see if it worked, because I might have had the same name somewhere. 1, 2. Yeah, I still have it. See, he saved it. Good. So if you have more than two setting, more than one setting, you have to save as a JSON file. Okay, so I now tend to tell everybody, because there's composers who want to give a Max patch with a different settings, and to people who don't have Max. And the problem with that is, remember when the JSON, save the JSON file prompt appear? If you don't own a Max, the program, you cannot save. So that's a problem. So what we do is, you just have to remember this. Save mode. Yeah, you just have to write it on your forehead somewhere. and then file usage mode 1. I know, it's yucky. I think this should be the default, but it is not. So, okay, so now I erased my setting because I reloaded, right? I think, oh, it's still there? Okay, good. So now I'm going to change my... you know what, let's just do this. Instead of a store 1, 2, of course, be very more elegant way to do, I guess, is to use the lowest $1 message. So now I'm going to make a third setting by, it's just something different. Different, something Different. And go up some amount. Small number, small number, come on. There you go. Okay, so now there is a third setting. So I'm going to save this as a 3. And let's recall 1, 2, 3. Right? It's 1, 2, oops. 1, 2, 3. 2, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so now, I edited that, so I have to save, and it will still ask for my JSON. Oh, it doesn't. Hey, look. So, you see that? It didn't ask for my JSON file, right? So, that's good. Here, I'm going to go like this. And let's say my performer changed something, the settings during the performance, where you're in California, your performance in New York, or vice versa. Oh, you know, my venue, I needed this. Maybe I need it like that. So that's my third setting instead of what Composer gave you. So now let's save, right? Now 1, 2, 3. Okay, I am not saving this batch. I'm closing it. It doesn't ask for your JSON file. So although your performer does not have, have your the Max program, you can still give a pattern storage file. As long as you give them the MariTest JSON file, the original one, right? So you can make a sort of a default setting of yourself, the one that you made, but then you can tell them that you can, the performer can store his or her own settings without having the Max, to have bought the Max program. Okay, that's it.